وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I want to speak about things that cause the iman to increase. There are things that if a person does, it will increase their iman. We, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we believe that the iman increases and it decreases. It increases in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it decreases in the obedience of shaitan. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm just going to mention some of the things that can increase your iman. And these are not the only things that can increase your iman. There are many more things. But I'm just going to mention some bi-idhnillahi al-kareem for this episode. The first one inshallah ta'ala is al-ilmu al-nafi', beneficial knowledge. تعلم العلم النافع, learning beneficial knowledge, attaining, gaining beneficial knowledge increases your iman. And ignorance, which is the opposite, it reduces your iman. The question here is, increasing or attaining or gaining beneficial knowledge, what does it mean? What is beneficial knowledge? I'm going to quote two great Imams, Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali and Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, both of whom mentioned what it means by beneficial knowledge. Let's start with Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali has a book on this. He called it فضل علم السلف على علم الخلف, which I encourage every student of knowledge to try to buy that book and to read it, where he talks about the knowledge of the pious predecessors, their knowledge in comparison to the knowledge of those who came later. He says in his book, فَالْعِلْمُ النَّافِعُ هُوَ ضَبْطُ نُصُوصِ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ وَفَهْمُ مَعَانِيهَا وَالتَّقَيُّدُ فِي ذَلِكَ بِالْمَأْثُورِ عَنِ الصَّحَابَةِ وَالتَّابِعِينَ وَتَابِعِيهِمْ فِي مَعَانِي الْقُرْآنِ وَالْحَدِيثِ. He said beneficial knowledge is, it is to be precise, to have precision in the textual evidences, yani the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Beneficial knowledge is the book, knowing the book of Allah. Beneficial knowledge is, number two, he said, is knowing the ahadiths of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Beneficial knowledge is what? Knowing the statements, the actions of the Sahabas and their students, the Tabi'een, and their students, the tabi'in students, يعني تابعوا التابعين, knowing the statements and the speeches and the belief of the three noble generation. He said this is beneficial knowledge. I repeat, beneficial knowledge is knowing the Qur'an, knowing the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a good portion of it. Also knowing what? Also having the statements and the belief and the actions of the Sahabas, the companions of the Prophet, the Tabi'een, the students of the companions, the Tabi'u Tabi'een, which are the students of the companions, having their statements, their actions, and their belief, that's knowledge. If you hear a lecture where it's absent, yani the person is not quoting Quran, he's not quoting hadiths, he's not quoting to you the statements of the early generation and their belief and their statements, yani this person is not giving you beneficial knowledge. You have to understand that. Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, he also gave a definition of what beneficial knowledge means. He said, وَالْمُرَادُ بِالْعِلْمِ الشَّرْعِي, the meaning that it means, Islamic knowledge. He said it means الَّذِي يُفِيدُ مَا يَجِبُ عَلَى الْمُكَلَّفِ مِنْ أَمْرِ دِينِهِ فِي عِبَادَاتِ وَمُعَامَلَاتِ وَالْعِلْمُ بِاللَّهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ. When you say I'm attaining Islamic knowledge and I'm gaining Islamic knowledge, And when the scholars say that Islamic knowledge is virtuous over the worldly knowledge, and what does Islamic knowledge mean? Because Islamic knowledge is beneficial knowledge. What does it mean? It means, he said, it is that which benefits you as a person, and you gain from it what is obligatory on you. And this knowledge that you're learning is that which is obligatory on you. There are things you must do, and you have to go and pray salah now. You're learning how to pray. You have to fast in the month of Ramadan. You're learning how to fast. You need to do hajj. You're learning how to do hajj. You need to give zakat. You're learning the ahkam related to zakat. You're going to get married. You need to learn the do's and the don'ts in marriage. Yani these are things which you are going to go forward in doing, having knowledge of those things. The scholars, they refer to that as ilmul hal, the knowledge that you need at that moment. The knowledge that is obligatory and mandatory on you. That knowledge, you must come with. And that knowledge is fi ibadati wa mu'amalati. That knowledge can be in acts of worship, and I mentioned it, like al-tahara, al-salah, al-zakah, al-sawm, and al-hajj. And it can also be in mu'amalat, your transactions, buying and selling, marriage, and etc. And then he said, wal-ilmu billahi wa sifati, and knowledge of Allah, His names and attributes. And a person doesn't even know who Allah is. He does not know who Allah is, has no knowledge and understanding of Allah. If you asked him, where is Allah? He doesn't know. If he was to ask, okay, what is Allah's characteristics and attributes? What are the names of Allah? He has no knowledge of it. This is knowledge you must have. And you have to come with. وَلِذَٰلِكَ the poet, he said, وَبَعْدُ فَالتَّوْحِيدُ عِلْمٌ يَمُّلُ عَلَى الْعُلُومِ كُلِّهَا وَيَفْضُلُ قَدْ أَوْجَبَ الرَّحْمَنُ مِنْهُ قَدْرًا لَيْسَ يَصِحُ الدِّينُ حَتَّى يُذْرَى. And Tawheed is a must for every one of us. We have to know our Tawheed. We have to know worshipping Allah, how to worship Him, what are the things that can nullify our ibadah, what are the things that can destroy it, what does La ilaha illallah mean, what are the conditions of La ilaha illallah, what are the prerequisites of La ilaha illallah, what are the pillars of La ilaha illallah. And knowing all of this is a knowledge that everybody needs to have. That is al-ilm al-nafi' in summary, brothers and sisters. Allah created us, brothers and sisters, and brought us into this world to have knowledge. Yani you are in this world to gain knowledge, Islamic knowledge. That's what Allah said in the ayah, Allahu alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawati wa min al-ardi mithlahunna yatanazzalu al-amru baynahunna li ta'lamu anna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir. لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. Allah is telling us that He created the seven heavens and He created the seven earths. He created everything in between the seven heavens and everything in between the earths. Allah created it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He sends down His commands from high above. Why does He do all of this? Why did He create all of this? Allah says, لِتَعْلَمُوا, so you can know. Know what? لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. To know that Allah has the ability over everything. Yani knowing Allah's characteristics and attributes. You were created to know Allah. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. And to know that Allah encompassed everything with knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He raises the people of knowledge and He raises them. Not just the day of judgment in Jannah, but He raises their iman as well. How does He? And what's the evidence for that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Qur'an, يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. Allah raised the believers over the disbelievers. And the believers are higher than the disbelievers. A believer is better than 1,000 disbelievers. But not all of the believers are the same. Within the believers, who are the best? Ahlul ilm. The people of what? The people of knowledge. Allah raised them from within the believers. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala asked us a rhetorical question. We don't have to answer it. The answer is clear already. Allah says, أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا يَحْذَرُ الْآخِرَةَ وَيَرْجُو رَحْمَةَ رَبِّهِ قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah asked us a question. He said, the one who knows and the one who doesn't know, are they the same? That they can't be the same. They're not the same. The one who knows is better than the one who doesn't know. So beneficial knowledge, my beloved brothers and sisters, increases your iman. إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. The ones who truly fear Allah, who are conscious of Allah, who are consistently fearful, and Ahlul Ilm, the people of knowledge, are always scared of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're conscious of Him. The people of knowledge, as I mentioned to you, are people who've gathered between beneficial knowledge and righteous action, and combined between the two. It's not just information that they have. They have knowledge, and they also have what? They have information, and they have actions to back that up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made the people of knowledge a testimony and a witness. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He said, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, what did He do? He used the people of knowledge as a witness. And if someone was to ask you today, أخي, did you do this? And you say, yeah, I did it. And someone says, okay, who's your witness? And you say, so-and-so is my witness. That so-and-so that you chose has to be someone who's reliable. If you choose someone who's not a reliable person, people are going to be like, sorry, you're not going to believe that person. So you're going to choose someone you know is reliable, right? وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. Allah has a greater example, and Allah is greater and higher than any example that we may give. Allah used the people of knowledge as a witness for the greatest thing, which is La ilaha illallah. شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَالْمَلَائِكَ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ. Allah mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala that there is none worthy of worship except me. Allah said that. The angels are my witness, and the people of knowledge are my witness, that I am the only one who deserves to be worshipped. What does that show you? It shows you the people of knowledge, Allah raised them. Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah is going to raise them subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also their iman is raised. They're not like the rest of the people. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us the hadith al-Imam Ahmad narrated is Muslim in hadith Abi Darda. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له طريقا إلى الجنة. That there is not a person who treads on a path, and he takes a path. That path he takes, he's trying to seek and gain Islamic knowledge. Except that Allah will give that person يوم القيامة a path to Jannah. And if you take a path to seek knowledge, Allah will give you a path to Jannah. So seeking knowledge raises a person. It increases your iman. The more you know Allah, the more your iman increases. The less you know Allah and His religion, the less iman you have. Yani your iman reduces. So that's the first one, inshallah ta'ala, that I wanted to mention. And there are many examples and there are many evidences for that, but that inshallah ta'ala should suffice. The second thing I believe increases your iman is qira'atul Qur'an, reciting the Qur'an, wa tadabburuh, and to contemplate over the Qur'an. And this Qur'an that we have with us, brothers and sisters, increases our iman. Reciting it, pondering over it, contemplating over it, increases your iman. That's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He glorified this Qur'an. And Allah referred to this Qur'an as a light and a beacon that shines everything for you. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَكَذَلِكَ أُوحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانُ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Allah referred to this Qur'an. He referred to it as a light and He referred to it as a soul. And in this Qur'an, when people are in darkness, you're not. You can see the path in front of you, because the Qur'an is shining it for you. Also, the Qur'an is what? The Qur'an is also, it gives you life. أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. Is it the same, the one who is dead? And Allah gave him life, revived him. Revived him with what? With the Qur'an. The Qur'an revives the person. It gives them life. So it increases your iman. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala told us that this Qur'an guides to the best of affairs. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. This Qur'an guides to the best of affairs. The best thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. This Qur'an is a cure for the heart, cure for the reduction of your iman. This Qur'an, if it was set down on the mountain, it will crumble and it will tremble. وَلَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُهَا لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. That this Qur'an, if it was to come down on the mountains, the mountain will tremble. When it comes down on the heart of a believer, how can it not move it? It does. The true believer, when the Qur'an comes down on his heart, it moves it and his iman increases. إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آيات زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. The believers, when they read the Quran, it increases their iman. Based on the ayah, the Quran increases it. It increases it. Why does it increase it? Because it's guidance and it's mercy. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرًا لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. This Quran, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he said, we sent it down, Muhammad. We sent this Quran down as a guidance. This Quran clarifies everything for the people. This Quran is a mercy. This Quran is a glad tiding for the believers. Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَقَدْ جِئْنَاهُمْ بِكِتَابٍ فَصَّلْنَاهُ. We've sent down the Quran on them and it clarifies everything, distinguishes falsehood from the truth. وَلَقَدْ جِئْنَاهُمْ بِكِتَابٍ فَصَّلْنَاهُ فَصَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى هُدًى وَرَحْمَةٍ. This Quran came down to clarify everything for them, to distinguish everything for them. It came to guide them and it came to send down on them what? It also came down to send them on mercy and also glad tidings. This Quran increases your heart, iman, brothers and sisters. But it's not just mere recitation. The Quran is not just alfaz that we just recite. يُقِيمُونَ حُرُوفَهُ وَيُضَيِّعُونَ حُدُودَهُ. That you just read the wordings and then you forsake the boundaries that the Quran has set for you. The Quran needs amal. The Quran requires what? Amal. It requires amal. That's why some of the Salaf, like Qatadat ibn Da'ama, Sa'id ibn Jubayr, and others, it was transmitted from them when it came to the ayah, يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. They said, يَعْمَلُونَهُ حَقَّ عَمَلِهِ. That they act upon the Quran the way it deserves to be acted upon. They act upon the Quran. They do what the Quran commands them to do. The poet, he said, بَدَأْتُ بِبِسْمِ اللَّهِ شَاطِبِي in his nazm. He says, بَدَأْتُ بِبِسْمِ اللَّهِ فِي النَّظْمِ أَوَّلًا تَبَارَكَ رَحْمَنَ الرَّحِيمًا وَمَوْئِلًا وثنيت صلى الله ربي على الرضا محمد المهدى إلى الناس مرسلا وعترتي ثم الصحابة ثم من تلاهم على الإحسان بالخير وبلا وثلثت أن الحمد لله دائما وما ليس مبدوءا به أجدم العلا وبعد فحبل الله فينا كتابه فجاهد به حبل العدا متحبلا وأخلق به إذ لئس يخلق جدة جديد مواليه على الجد مقبلا وقارئه المرضي قر مثاله كالأترج عليه مريحا وموكلا هو المرتضى أما إذا كان أمة. يعني the Quran is just the person, the recitation and the reading and the contemplating over the Quran, the joy that they get from it. وإن كتاب الله أوثق شافع وأغنى غناء واهبا متفضلا وخير جليس لا يمل حديثه وترداد يزداد فيه تجملا وحيث الفتى يرتاع في ظلماته من القبر يلقاه سلم متهللا هنيئا مريئا والداك عليهما ملابس أنوار من التاج والحلى. يعني the Quran, brothers and sisters, I don't know anything I can say to you that can truly impact your life, that can truly change the course of your life better than the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no lecture or reminder that you listen to that can change you better than the Quran. I don't think any Muslim should believe that there is anything better to listen to and think over and contemplate and take in than the words of Allah. It's better than anything. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of the Quran, the people who live by it, implement it, stand by it, protect it. ولذلك ابن القيم رحمه الله, when it came to قوله تعالى وقال الرسول يا ربي إن قومي اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا, ابن القيم said that the boycotting of the Quran that this ayah is referring to, that there's some people who are going to boycott the Quran, from the boycotting is with it's to stay away from reciting it. And also to what? To stay away from pondering over it. If you don't ponder over the Quran, because that's why it was sent down. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكُ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِي أَفَلَا يَتَدَّبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا أَفَلَا يَتَدَّبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا أَفَلَمْ يَدَّبَّرُوا الْقَوْلَ. يعني the Quran was sent down for a tadabbur, contemplation. If you don't do that, you're going against what the Qur'an was sent down. Allah nazzala ahsana al-hadithi kitaban mutashabihan mathani taqsha'iru minhu julud alladhina yakhshawna rabbahum thumma talinu juluduhum wa qulubuhum ila dhikrillah. And the Qur'an, when it's recited, the believer, talinu qulubuhum, their hearts become soft because it increases their iman. And there are many more other things that can increase a person's iman. Those two were the most important ones that I, inshallah ta'ala, that come to mind. And there are many other more things, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah make us from the people who take these things on board and take the best of speech and implement it in their life. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.